Welcome to Barkercise, helping dog owners provide the best exercise, enrichment, and healthcare for their dogs. The two types of Akita are the Japanese Akita, or Akita Inu, and the American Akita. The main differences between the two are the size and a slightly different appearance. The Japanese Akita has a size range from 23 to 25 inches, 59 to 64 centimeters, and can weigh between 65 and 120 pounds, 30 to 55 kilograms. The American Akita can grow to a height of 24 to 26 inches, 61 to 71 centimeters, and can weigh between 70 and 130 pounds, 32 and 60 kilograms. When it comes to the exercise needs of the two types of Akita, there is no real difference. Every dog is an individual, so the energy levels and exercise requirements can vary from dog to dog regardless of which type of Akita they are. How much exercise does an Akita need? Although the Akita is not a super hyper high energy breed, they are still fairly active and energetic. They require at least an hour of daily exercise and activity to maintain good health and condition. Up to 2 hours a day of activity would be even better. There are three main types of exercise and activity you must provide your Akita every day: a daily walk, purposeful activity, and mental stimulation and enrichment. The daily walk. The daily walk is essential for an Akita not only to release some pent-up energy. The walk allows your Akita to stimulate the mind with the sights, sounds, and smells they come across. The length of the daily walk should ideally be between 30 to 45 minutes. This can be just once a day, or two walks a day would be better if your schedule allows. Dogs also like routine, so try to schedule the walk for around the same time each day. Daily walks are much better than nothing all week and a big walk at the weekend. If your Akita has good recall and comes on command, walks at the park off the leash are ideal. Alternatively, you can use a long line to allow them more freedom while maintaining control. Not all Akitas are good with other dogs, so ensure you are aware of any potential situations that may arise. You can add extra resistance to the walk by using a weighted vest or dog backpack. It is recommended that no more than 10% of their body weight be added. This is more than sufficient to tire them and strengthen their muscles without overworking them. Other ways of increasing the resistance on the walk are to walk on sand or include uphill sections in the walk. Purposeful activity. The daily walk is a crucial component of any dog's daily exercise. In addition to going for walks, it is important to provide other types of purposeful activity and exercise in your Akita's daily exercise routine. This will aid in burning pent-up energy, provide enrichment, and keep their muscles strong. Some suggested activities for an Akita include a game of fetch or frisbee, flirt pole exercise, and tug of war. For more exercise ideas for an Akita, click the link in the description below. Mental stimulation and enrichment. All dogs need an outlet for their minds. If they are not provided the opportunity to challenge their minds, they will come up with their own ways to achieve this. This usually manifests itself in bad behavior such as excessive barking, digging, escaping, and other destructive behaviors. Some ways to provide mental stimulation and enrichment include puzzle toys, nose games, and environmental enrichment. How much exercise does an Akita puppy need? The exercise needs of a puppy are quite different from those of an adult dog. With puppies, their bones, muscle, and joints are still growing and developing. Overly strenuous walks are not necessary and, in fact, could possibly cause harm. An activity that has high impact on the joints should also be avoided. The best exercise for a young puppy is free play with age-appropriate toys. Socializing with other puppies or friendly adult dogs is a great way to burn some of that puppy energy along with teaching them the social skills they need. As your puppy gets older, you can take them for short informal walks, allowing them to sniff and explore and get used to being on a leash. Puppies under 3 months probably haven't had all their vaccinations, so shouldn't be walked in public. Check with your vet when it is all right to venture out to the park or street. The general rule of thumb for walking a puppy is around 5 minutes for every month of age. For a 4-month-old puppy, a walk of 15 to 20 minutes is enough. Monitor your Akita puppy on the walk for signs such as lagging behind, lying down, or panting. End the walk if they seem too tired. Mental stimulation is important for puppies and can tire them just as much as physical activity. How much exercise does an older Akita need? As a dog gets older, they become less active and have lower energy levels. However, it is still important that they remain reasonably active to keep their joints and muscles mobile and to manage their weight. Many dogs develop arthritis as they age. Exercise for them becomes a balancing act. It is important to keep their joints mobile and manage weight, but too much can make them sore. In summary, although the Akita is not a super hyper high energy breed, they are still fairly active and energetic. They require at least an hour of daily exercise and activity to maintain good health and condition. Up to 2 hours a day of activity would be even better. This should include a daily walk of 30 to 45 minutes with additional purposeful activity and play. It is also important to provide mental stimulation to challenge their minds and prevent boredom. Let us know in the comments how much and ways you exercise your Akita. Like and subscribe for more videos on dog exercise, enrichment, and overall healthcare.